Of the Talk C3PR.
Auf dem Kanal von Chaos Zone
you
TV
are
beim
listening to the English translation
C3.
Of Chaos Zone
Wir
TV.
Spaß an Tag 4 und genau, hier geht's weiter mit einem
This talk
auf Deutsch, der allerdings auf
will be translated as you already know.
Das heißt,
your translators will be Celeste and B.
Solltet ihr da die Sprache umstellen können. So, the next talk will be given in German, but there should be translations, so you can switch the language below the video.
Everyone who now found us, warm welcome. If you want to ask questions to the talk, you can use IRC and Mastodon and Twitter.
And
how exactly can be found below the video in the tab chat.
Genau, und der
the name is C3PR. How does it work?
Und
so it is about robots.
Roboter, denn wir begrüßen unseren Speaker.
Have fun Honky. With Honky. That's the name of the speaker. Good morning.
Guten Morgen.
I hope all of you fell out of bed well.
Wenn nicht, dann könnt ihr natürlich.
If not, feel free to watch it in the recording. So it's not obvious what this is about. It is an open hardware Wi-Fi robot. It's basically a side project that we started 2020 to enable remote events. Because we can't meet in real life, but we can have robots running around in real life. So we wanted to create a platform without any clouds from China, Russia or the US. So we just got started. The GitHub page is right here on the slide and it will also be mentioned in the end again. So what does such a robot consist of? I like saying robots is the combination of many professions.
Man muss sich wirklich darum kümmern.
You have to take care of things that programmers don't have to take care of and what the electrician doesn't have to take care of. You have to take care of everything. You have to work with servers, you have to work with software. And these parts are listed here. So the ESP32 is basically the CPU. Then you will need something like a camera. And that's already quite a lot for hardware. Because a video feed is challenging. You need a motor driver. That's basically a small chip or PCB that can run a motor in two directions, forward and backward, for example. That's not trivial with a motor. And then you need motors, of course. The correct specifications. You want to be able to program the thing using USB, so you need an interface.
Irgendwie programmieren können und dieses Programmieren geht auch so wie das alte Herren machen oder junge Schüler oder wie das die
alten. For example, using platform IO, how many fancy people are doing it nowadays. And of course, a battery management system, because you have to have a battery and you have to be able to load it and charge it and to create a constant voltage from it. So those are a few parts as well to be considered. So the ESP32, I don't think I have to say much about it. It's a pretty much standard these days. It's a small chip, about a thumbnail size. So not the whole board you see here, but just a chip in the middle.
Also nur der schwarze Anteil, nicht der blaue.
It's a 32-bit CPU with two cores. So the 8266 was a single core, and this now is a dual core, actually a triple core, because there is a low power CPU as well that is enables an ultra low power mode. So it's 240 MHz, which is a lot, and 520 kilobytes of RAM. So if you compare that to an Arduino, this is really usable.
Ist aber so eine Sache, wenn man damit
so if you want to send pictures, it quickly gets bigger than this RAM. And these interfaces are listed here. The serial connection SPI is for hardware, I2C. All those are for communication with other hardware.
Mit dem man da bis 128 Geräten normalerweise reden kann und I2S ist so
I2S is for sound usually. So direct access memory stuff doesn't really matter.
Ist ja auch wurscht.
We will need that for now.
Nicht solange wir nicht über Ton reden, weil das Video
because we are doing only video for now. Internally it uses 3.3 volts. That's also something you have to think about. Where does it come from? And of course, we need something creating these 3.3 volts, depending on what kind of battery, what kind of power you want to use or waste. And if you're using a battery, you want to save as much energy as possible. So we have ADCs, analog digital converters, DACs, digital analog converters, so one can create analog signals and one can transform analog to digital and the other way around. And the great thing is, it's rather cheap, it's $3. Of course, you need some periphery, for example, 3.3 volts, but those are usually cent amounts.
Die ESP-Cam ist quasi ein Nachfolger
davon. That's already a second version. It also includes an ESP32. On the back side here, we can see it in this picture, but in the next. But it also has a bit more RAM, because, as already mentioned, pictures need more RAM, especially 1600 by 1200 pixels. Then we have this OVH2640, we have a flash LED, so a slightly brighter LED, and this basically takes as much power as the whole system together. And theoretically, this would also work with an SD card.
Und diese SD-Karte ist auf diesem Metallkörper
unterhalb der Kamera below
zu sehen.
The camera damit here on the picture.
Theoretisch auch arbeiten, um da zum Beispiel günstige Webcams and oder so.
With that we could create timeless cameras or something like that, rather cheaply.
Habt im Hinterkopf die
but still, the resolution is not amazing.
Aber für doch schon mal so eine Baustelle oder so ein Hausbau oder so ein Bau
follow oder was a tree auch growing or a house being built, it's enough.
Ist das Ding ausreichend? Das ganze
the thing costs so around $5 in China, so it's rather cheap as well.
Total schnell viele
Modelle, so you can get
ich hab davon
several of them.
Die Qualität easily. Ist ausreichend.
Quality
Kameramodul besser oder schlechter,
varies a bit. Sometimes the camera is better or
kann man auch
not as good, but you can also just buy a camera
und da ist es auch nicht so schlimm, wenn
if you're building up broken anyway. And then it's not too bad if some of them are broken, but over 90% coming from China directly were great. And some had some cheap module that I replaced. So here the comparison, on the upper side the ESP32 with the whole pinouts,
also da kommen halt
so a lot of options, many possibilities,
viele Drähte,
that's basically just wires
mit dem man Dinge
to turn stuff on and off,
kann.
And
die Pins in der unteren Reihe
the lower row is less usable because that's basically the internal flash memory,
dran, also da, wo das Programm
but the pins on the side,
pins an der Seite
they are very usable.
Nutzbar.
And below we see the ESP cam.
ESP cam auf der Rückseite, jetzt wo der ESP zu
so
sehen.
This is the other side from what we saw before.
Andere Seite als im Bild davor.
There are a lot fewer pins.
Und dieses deutlich
weniger Pins kann es noch mal auf die Füße difficult fallen, because we can see a ground and some communication.
Auf der rechten Seite
we have 3.3 and 5 volts.
Also sind also wirklich
but there are no, not many GPIO pins, so general input and output pins. That's the ones you want to use for communication, if they are not used otherwise, for example for the SD card. Sometimes they are free as well, but it is a challenge. It can be a challenge. This ESP cam also needs power, so 180 milliamps at 5 volts, so a normal power
power bank can
run this for
12
hours and longer.
If
it's just standing there, even longer.
Wenn die,
if the flash LED is on, so a very bright LED, it takes a lot more energy and heats up considerably.
So
you can see the numbers on screen.
And
we can get 25 frames per second with a lower resolution. And of course this is JPEG compressed. And 2 frames per second with a higher resolution. And of course it does matter what kind of antenna you are using. And that is quite useful to improve your connection, because sometimes it's not the memory that's limiting, but how quickly you can move data around. The antennas, well, you can buy anything in China. Often it's just a piece of wire. And if it's 6.3 centimeters, more or less, then it can function as an antenna. But be careful, you can mess up there quickly, easily. Another important thing, this has no programmer. So you cannot directly connect USB. The one on top usually also doesn't have that, but it's normally on a developer board. So there is a serial to USB chip on there. Ideally, it's an FTDI chip, not always, but that doesn't really matter. So, what I want to mention, you can't add a USB directly to the USB.
Here's an FTDI, and you can also search for this. It has the least amount of external components. It has the best ability to be controlling it, and this is for this reason my favorite, I would implement this with the robot. It's a little bit expensive, so it costs at least $2 or $3, but it altogether should cost less than $10. If you want to buy something from China or something like that, then there might be all of the best chips you can imagine, but if you can buy something for a dollar, there's no FTDI. It's too cheap for that. So you want to be paying $2 or $3 at the very least. So you have to look at what's available. What I wanted to say is that this can easily connect to the camera, which is,
it
has 5 volts and also 3.3 volts. The one is taking from the USB from the camera and then controlling it this way. And when you want to the USB talk, then you can also use a 3.3 volts. Or you can choose for a Wi-Fi, but in this case you need a little bit more electricity. And then you would choose the high voltage.
Im Wesentlichen, welche Drähte man verbinden muss.
There's a ground on the USB, and this is the communication channel,
und VCC, was die Versorgungsspannung ist.
Ihr müsstet quasi immer 4 Drähte mit dem ESP. And then you have to play with it to connect the USB camera.
Zum nächsten Punkt,
when you want to build the robot, you have to connect the motor. The motor must be driven by something, and it has to be connected to the microcontroller.
Diese Drähte, die da dran sind, ja, also diese Drähte, mit denen man quasi nach außen kommuniziert.
So there's a signal here. There are different signals you can use to connect the information that's being
und wo man weniger Last dranhängen möchte. Also man kann da quasi nicht, also für eine LED könnte es gerade noch so reichen, dass ihr dann
you can have a milliampere LED.
Aber sobald man da einen Motor dranhängt, dann bricht das ganze System zusammen.
It's a lower power.
Die Versorgungsspannung bricht zusammen, das ganze Ding startet sich neu und das funktioniert nicht.
There's also a problem here that you must control it forwards and then also backwards. It could be a plus or a minus or the other way around. then
und dafür braucht man halt irgendeine
Art you need to be having a switch somehow.
So in den Jahren ergeben hat oder schon seit Ewigkeiten besteht und auch überall benutzt wird, zum Beispiel bei fahrenden Sesseln oder auch bei kleineren.
You can find these all over the place. There are different versions of them.
Wobei Waschmaschine, egal, lasst euch nicht verwirren, ist dieser Haarbrücke.
Haarbrücke,
weil das so ein bisschen.
Brücke is the name of this one that I've used. You can check this on Wikipedia. It's very, very well documented what it is and what other extra chips you need and how to build it together. This is 1.2 amperes for the current. That's really consistent there.
Er kann auch mal kurz 3,2
It can go to 3.2 amperes as a peak.
Losfahren oder sowas
kann man. You can also do that.
Dann ist wichtig, wie man
mit and then it's important, how do you speak to these, how do you communicate to these components here?
Volt schalten können, würden dann auch mit 2,7 Volt
you can talk to it with 2.7 volts. It's
wunderbar. Also der kann halt mit 2,7 bis
5.5 voltage. This range is perfect.
3,3 Volt Signalpegeln arbeitet.
So it really functions really well.
Kostet im Originalzustand
halt wieder original,
version,
then
ich habe es halt jetzt hier nur mal, weil das Bild so schön deutlich war.
It costs only $5 directly from.
Selber bestellen und herstellen will, kostet der Chip.
But $5 is directly from the manufacturer, or there are some components you can get for just as low as $1 when it's not directly from the manufacturer. So.
So. Jetzt haben wir
we have a camera,
Kamera, wir haben
we have a microcontroller, we have a motor, and we have a controller for the motor. We have a motors, here there are different ones you can use as well. Here it's,
also wenn
we are calling them yellow motors just based on the colors here.
Dann seht ihr oftmals genau diese Motoren, wie sie oben auseinander oder rechts.
You can see how they're built.
Das sind Getriebemotoren, also das sind quasi die.
They're very inexpensive.
Sehr schnell drehen mit einem Getriebe, das ist dann.
And they move very slowly.
Diese sehr langsame Bewegung.
But it comes with the advantage that it's very powerful or robust, even though they're slow.
Ohne weiteres.
They're very strong.
Die Haltbarkeit
kommt it also depends on which components you're choosing. They range in price between 50 cents and $3, so they have various degrees of quality.
Sind diese gelben Motoren aber bekannt und benutzt.
What you don't see very often is on the first slide that I had this gray motor. And it's very, very small.
Damit kann man halt
and you can really build some tiny applications with this and connect them very well. And then we'll get back to this later. So, right, you can have various motors and then various motor controllers.
Könnt ihr da also wunderbar mitarbeiten, egal was.
Yeah, and the yellow ones are very practical, like I've said.
Wenig Strom brauchen und dann halt auch ziemlich gut halten.
So in the logistic during the RC3, we built something like this. That was the best picture, unfortunately. It was robot number 3. It's also connected to a Jitsi. You can check that out on the Twitter account. That's what it could look like. So it's basically a power bank providing the motor drivers from the red PCB and also the black USB camera and then the two motors on a platform and you're done with the telepresence robot. It can drive around and well, you still need to provide the software. We didn't talk about that. And now there's the programming part, because right now it was electronics. If you want to program, you can usually get started with the Arduino IDE. It's very good for beginners. There are a few downsides, though. Of course, it was made for the Arduino, so everything else you have to patch into there somehow, but it can be done, so it is compatible with the ESP32.
Es hat so ein bisschen Probleme mit der
The library compatibility is a bit difficult, so if you have a few different versions or you open it after a year, it could be that the code just broke because the libraries were updated and it's not working anymore.
Wie gesagt,
so it's a great start.
Anfang.
to have something blink and to learn something, but as soon as it's more complex, you want to be with the cool kids, and the cool kids, they use Platform.io.
Platform.io
That's the editor on steroids.
So
it's fancy and supports different libraries, different ports. It can do different ports, code completion, Git integration. It's very nice. Actually, it's just a plugin for VS Coding or Visual Studio. So it also takes a lot of CPU just for having the cursor blink.
But
yeah, I wouldn't want to miss this anymore, because even after you, if you open it after a year, and that happens quite a lot of time, then you want to have a dependable build, and that works better with this. You can pin library versions, and if you want to switch between Arduino or ESP, then sometimes it can be quite annoying in the Arduino IDE, and here it's quite easy. Every project is already set to a certain platform. The source code to our project I showed you in the GitHub, and it comes, Blink will come back later, because right now we haven't programmed anything. The program we wrote or we used is basically creating a website, so the ESP connects to a Wi-Fi of your choice, and is then just taking part in that, and provides a web server on port 80. And there, like on the screenshot, you can see a menu, and there you can start the stream and get a still. So make a screenshot. People who worked with that before will recognize it, because it was the example project from the ESPCAM, and we just expanded that. And this library I linked here, this is the project basically, and extended it for the light working properly and the motors working properly. And we further extended that project so we can control the robot using the keyboard, WASD, you know, the usual. And someone also added that you can use a gamepad. Not certain about the name right now, but you can also use like an Xbox controller now. And there's also the option to use a joystick in touch, but that's not completely done yet.
Auf jeden Fall ist es möglich, dass
die it's possible to control this
auch in diesem Projekt,
in several ways.
Haben, auf,
and what we saw on C3 Logistics, there was a chat control even. Yeah, so this way you get something you can control. First time we used this in September at the Datenspuren. And here we see a screenshot from Jitsi, and it was possible in DN42, which is something like a VPN, to control these robots at the event. And there we built this small world to make it more interesting, so these umbrellas and the blinking things. Datenspuren was an event in September, so there was already a lockdown. And as mentioned in the beginning, this project was just for that reason, because we wanted to meet up without meeting up in real life. And that's also where we worked with Work Adventure for the first time. What I want to get at is we did that in September, and it worked surprisingly well.
Das ganze Projekt gab's
the whole project also was used in the technical or technological collections in Dresden,
quasi eine andere Gruppe von Leuten gebaut.
Dort konnte man durch die Kunstausstellung drive through
auch wieder mit an
art exhibition
Roboter ausleihen und damit dann rumdüsen.
I still control it with WASD. I'm not certain the URL is
wenn sie nicht geht, seid freundlich,
running right now. If it doesn't, please behave. Another thing we weren't really talking about yet, but a robot also needs
dass man sich
a construction, so it needs a shell.
Also wie soll der Roboter,
how should everything fit together?
Sein? Auch da
sind yes, von a lot of work was done by Kurt and Vigalis, I think.
Haben,
so they were building models using FreeCurt,
auch da ist
and a lot of stuff is in the repository.
Da kann man sich quasi
so you can also work on that if you'd like.
Und dort,
and
sind
take part in the work, and a lot of constructions are possible. I can also show a few in the Q&A later. So, we were talking about the distinct parts, and of course you can wire it up and solder stuff, and then you have bad connections. Or you just sit down and try to create a custom PCB to make things simpler. And I, or we tried a little.
Wo, wie hier
and here you can see the ESP cam top left, and then the red programmer for the USB communication, and in the middle, the black PCB that's new. That's the one we created.
Und,
and that includes the motor controller
genau
that we had on a on another red PCB before from SparkFun.
Aber
but
ich,
now we also saved some GPIOs because if you want to
möchte, kann der drive der Motorcontroller quasi zwei Eingangssignale
forwards or backwards.
Da wir aber eigentlich bloß vorwärts oder rückwärts fahren sollen, können wir da halt damit
MOSFETs. It was blocking, but now we can use MOSFETs. So altogether we are saving two pins, we can now use for something else.
Auf der ersten Version oder 1.2,
das and ist yeah, schwammig, one or two pins,
war auch noch ein Bug Boost Converter drauf.
That changed slowly.
Heißt, dass er halt nicht nur Spannung
it was a fluid change. And yeah, we have Bug and Boost Converters that can change voltages around. So even if we were using 5 or 9 volts, we could also now have input voltage of 2 to 12 volts. So whatever you could find lying around, you can now use that. Down to 2 volts, we can use that power and transform it into stable 5 or 9 volts.
Das war so ein bisschen mäßig, weil das hat halt die
Anzahl der Platine good and bad. It doubled the parts we needed.
Das Ding war auch nicht ganz
and it was rather expensive, actually.
Das per Hand zu machen. Und deswegen
so we davon so did not keep doing that. The other parts are rather self-explanatory. Some motors, Antenne, some wires. The second variation
die Variante war dann
so, the second version of our PCB, we again created a few more, but without the backside. So that was rather optional, and
I think
we created 10 or 12 robots of these.
And
that's also the version we were using at the Datenspur. But that had one big drawback. The programming was a bit more complex. So you had to get it away from power, bring GPIO0, IO0 to ground, reset it, program, reset, test, and a lot of unplugging, replugging. And that's just annoying, especially if you do it in a workshop. And to explain people how to program that,
und deswegen
so,
dann halt der Wunsch oder auch der Sinn
war, we wanted to simplify this.
Denn bei diesen ESP
because the developer boards are simpler as well. You just plug it in and say, now program, and it's resetting automatically, and it's programmed, and after programming, it gets restarted automatically as well. And that's something, that's a feature you just want. Not no unplugging, replugging, and connecting to ground manually. So then there was the version 3.0. This version has an additional chip on the top right.
Also unten links ist der
U1, bottom left.
Der Motorcontroller oben rechts, das ist der FTDI.
Yeah, there's the FTDI chip, that's the serial to USB communication. And you can see it's rather densely packed. And back then it had mini USB, which was because the cheap boards that I showed before, they were using mini USB. And the nice thing is, we didn't have to buy them extra. So such a plug could, not the plug, the other part, could cost up to 50 cents if you're unlucky.
Diese Version 3.0 zu bestücken.
And yeah, we were then creating these, and that took half an hour to 45 minutes to populate that by hand. And that's not something you want to do, to sit down after work and populate this PCB. And there was another problem. The ESP camera, it includes an ESP, but to reset an ESP,
muss man
resetten oder halt pull specific pin to ground. So that has to be a specific voltage to restart. And on the camera, this pin has a nice
aber halt nie nach unten button, wird.
But it's das heißt, never pulled out. So it's difficult to restart this ESP properly, unless you take away the power, and that is a bit more complex as well.
Funktioniert, wenn der Mikrocontroller, der die serielle Kommunikation macht, halt ordentlich funktioniert.
That's a bit tricky and didn't work on first try as well.
Es hat sich dann rausgestellt.
It turned out it was just a weird.
Auf jeden Fall, als ich diese Platine nochmal machen musste, da habe ich dann drüber nachgedacht, hey, wie schlage ich jetzt eigentlich alle Probleme?
So, how do I take all these problems I have and go further and program it?
Dass ich eigentlich ja meine Uhr haben will und das Zeug irgendwie nicht selber mit der Hand bestücken will.
I don't want to do everything by hand here, of course.
Ja,
very easy.
Ich lasse das.
I let someone else do it.
Ersetze halt in dem Zuge auch gleich den Micro USB.
It's a micro USB or mini USB. It's on the other side of the plate.
Das ist Single Sided, also so, dass es auch quasi einseitig bestückbar ist, ohne dass es extra.
It doesn't take any more money to use the side.
So eine Produktionsstraße fahren lässt, dass dann halt, wenn man die Oberseite heiß macht, dass dann vielleicht Zeit
von
der Unterseite abfallen und sowas. Deswegen sind auch einseitig bestückte Platinen.
This is actually cheaper. It's cheaper to make when it's just one-sided here. And it's version 3.1. It has a difference. It's completely manufactured in China. It's already put together and it functions really well. So when you are searching for something that's already made, this is here.
Echte Teile bestellt und zwar bei Zulieferern, wo ich auch.
I ordered it privately.
Und dann habe ich halt auch die Gewissheit, dass ich da ein FTDI der.
Knew that the company FTDI was using it and I shouldn't have any worries that something was wrong. Everything is should be tip top here.
Genau, das Ding
this was manufactured. It took 4 to 6 weeks for it to be printed out. There are some fixed costs.
Hat dafür, dass solche kleinen Aufträge überhaupt angefangen werden. Und dann halt zusätzlich die Teile, die auf dem
Board. Then there are also parts of the board that are very tiny here, and we can take a look here. We're looking on the left side. There's the motor controller. There's the FDI. Under on the right side, we're seeing how all these things are set. This is looking at how the electricity is being programmed.
Und dieser, ja, sind
it can say, are we in programming mode or are we not?
In einem gewissen Zustand halt
we can turn it on or off here.
Ausgeschalten ist oder währenddessen er ausgeschalten wird, wird halt auch der
GPIO. It's a GPIO.
Auf Masse ziehen muss,
can, you can program auf, it through that.
Masse gezogen und der ESP
the USB
diesen beiden Voraussetzungen
also is coming through and can be programmed through that way.
Automatisch dieser GPIO 0 wieder von der Masse befreit. Und
there's also a reset button
fertigen Zustand auch wieder mit läuft ohne sich
then it's controlling if you're in programming mode or if you're not.
Ich nur zeigen, dass es dann doch so
these are parts of the pieces that I'm showing here
ja auch das hier
and I should make this public
sind alle öffentlich im
it should be in the repo if you want to take a look in the repository.
Die erste Fertigung, here, wie gesagt, hatte noch
the first finished component here.
Halt nicht gepasst haben, ist aber alles weniger tragisch. Der Prozess war sehr
all of the process I experienced was really professional. I was surprised by this.
Wenn man fünf
when you bestellt, order at least so five, then you are paying 20 euros each, and this is the fixed cost.
Die Teile.
auf der Platine. Wieder dran denken, dass zum Beispiel ein Teil.
So you can think about if you're using one side or two side, what you need.
Also erstmal schnell bei 5, 6, 7, 8 Dollar.
And if you are adding more details, then there will be $5 to $8 more. Löhne.
Wenn man jetzt
when you're ordering more than 10 pieces, then they should be about 12 euros each. When you're ordering 100 or more, then the cost will be lower.
Einen sehr hohen Anteil einfach an dem Kostenfaktor des Boards wollte ich quasi bloß.
Aufnehmen. And then I'll also make public the different prices so, das heißt, are available for these types of boards. Teile,
wir hatten
ESP, so we have a motor controller, FEII.
Wir haben irgendwie diese ersten paar Teile.
We have all these first pieces together, and then we have it all on one board, and we have it manufactured now.
Damit entfällt so dieses ganze Vertrag blöden. Jetzt haben wir dann quasi
now we are have a finished robot, and then we have a website where we can control the robot through.
Das Ding steuern möchte, ist es gar kein Problem.
Not a problem for a single person to do this directly. The problem is if you have a presentation or a group of people, and then what happens when you have multiple video signals, the robot isn't really optimized, so it's not, it's a small box that it has.
Damit beschäftigt hat, diese MJPEG-Kodierung zu machen. Jetzt gibt es zum Glück.
Luckily, there's a project already using MPEG.
Mit dem ist es
and then it's relatively easy to reach these cameras and to say here, robot, transmit me your camera picture and then you can control it.
Weil das halt auch zwei verschiedene
and then there's two different web servers.
Web-Server auf Port
80, there's one being controlled through Port 80 auf Port 81, and one through 180.
Und dann hat man mehrere
and then you have different possibilities here. So
das ist so ein proprietäres
you have Flash RTMP endpoints and you can use this through the internet.
Funktioniert auch so
halbwegs. It functions also really well.
So ein Protokoll, was auch eure Videos gerade
and then you have different videos that are distributed this way.
Ohne es zu wissen, in Kontakt gekommen seid, wenn ihr jetzt auf MediaCCC
seid. And when you go to the CCC site, then you also are using these types of encoding.
Das heißt, man sendet sein Video einmal an einen
you Server one,
und dieser Server verteilt das dann an
you have one server and then you have a different server that's distributing it further to smaller endpoints. And then you have ability to distribute the signal to multiple endpoints.
Wenn man das Ding dann ins
if you want to use Jitsi, you can also do this. You can use an MJPEG and you're using the so-called dummy interface.
Und diese virtuelle
and you have virtual cameras,
darum kümmert, dass das dann zum Beispiel
for example,
Browser ganz normal
benutzt can be used through the browser.
Man könnte dann zum Beispiel ein Chromium aufmachen.
You could in Chromium,
hier, nimm doch meine virtuelle
you can tell Jitsi, hey, can you connect my virtual camera too? And then you can show this within a Jitsi room.
Dass dort halt mehrere virtuelle
you can have multiple virtual cameras to control.
Die dann in einem OBS, also OBS,
we have OBS Studio as a program to use for this control. And then for a total stream, you can use, for example, the media.ccc stream. And then you can show all of the different robots together in real time.
Wenn man jetzt wirklich durch
RTMP when you're using MJMPEG
Webserver laufen lässt und mit HLS kodiert und so ein Kram, also das was quasi
and for instance this MJPEG is what Twitch uses for all of these real time programs.
Dauert es ungefähr so 7-8 Sekunden mindestens bis
but there's a delay time
doch durchaus mehr wenn es halt so
and when you have buffering then of course there's going to be a further delay and when you're controlling robots in real time this is actually too big of a delay.
Wenn man nur RTMP nimmt, also
so please use only RTMP P, and then you're having less than 50 milliseconds of delay here.
Kontrollsoftware reinpacke, also quasi so ein Video.
And it's able to pack in all together the video. And then you can control it this way, and then you can see the picture directly from it.
So, wir haben
jetzt so you have a robot.
Der macht sein Bild irgendwo hin. Das Bild kann
you can distribute the picture.
Und wir sehen das im Zweifel auch in Jitsi.
And then you see it all in Jitsi.
You still have a problem though.
Nämlich,
so sharing is caring.
Also wie mache ich das jetzt,
wenn so
ich
what can I do if I want to share a robot with several people?
Das Problem ist,
so the problem is that this website nicht cannot distinguish if it's one person or several people on a device. You can use a system that's also in the repo. It's called Rent-a-Robot. You can maybe slightly see it in a screenshot. Oh, by the way, that's the last talk from the Datenspuren. Sound is terrible, but you could have a look. It's online. So you can click on a robot, and were then represented with a you were then given a list of all active robots, and whatever one was available, you could click on it. And then this Nginx reverse proxy was opened. That was taking care of the picture of the website. And
dann ein Robot Operator quasi
a robot operator could then control the robot. As soon as you interrupted it for 60 seconds, the program stopped that control and opened it up for someone else controlling it again.
C3 Logistics, Tofu hat da was gebaut.
Someone also built it for text commands in a Jitsi project.
Man kann da abstimmen über 2 Sekunden Zeit.
So you had a pull and with left, right, up and down, and whatever got the most most votes, that was happening. It's also included in the Rocket World.
Wie man so einen Roboter steuert und wie man sich das teilt, ja, insert your ideas.
So, yeah, if you have an idea how to improve it or use it for your own events, there are basically no limits because we control everything, hardware, software, and also the server infrastructure. So we have basically our own cloud. Yeah, to do.
Genau, to do.
What would be nice is little things we would like to have. For example, RTMP stream. It would be nice if you could just start a robot and it would start the stream immediately, or if you would have maybe a button that would activate the stream. Why is that not happening? Why do we need this FFmpeg stuff? Well, RTMP was proprietary and you have to patch together things with packets, and that is a bit ugly. Then the robot operator stream. Well, as long as you are controlling the robot, you can't really see the picture, the video stream at the same time. You can use Jitsi on another tab, but it's not working nicely. Theoretically, there are a few pins still open. So GPIO 15, for example. You could add LED, or maybe even sound in and sound out with the Icecrea S, a lot of things are possible. Then you could think about if you have several of those robots, you could make a HaloCon or an advanced HaloCon, depending on what the next year brings and what we could do about events. Then we could have something like Robot Wars over the internet. And then we could also have it a bit more complex, not just the simple stuff. And maybe we could just order more PCBs. Because now it's a process that's basically finished. Well, it's basically pre-planned. You don't have to populate the PCBs anymore, and then you can, of course, make more. If you just order them, it also gets cheaper for everyone. I didn't start a Kickstarter or something like that, but if you are interested, let's talk. I can also coordinate everything. But you have to consider that such a robot with all the parts, so the ESP came $5, or $5. The PCB, let's say $10 to $15, that makes 15. Motors $2 to $3. So let's say we are $20. Then you get everything you need, $20. You can program it, you can control it, you have a camera, and the rest is just extras. A few cables, a case, printing a case is not too expensive. So an open source robot with Wi-Fi, with website controls, in that price category, with a full control, there are app bots or others. Maybe there are also ideas in the chat. Maybe someone solved it differently. It's possible. Of course, it's rather cheap. Maybe it's not completely done. So the first 80% are the easiest, the last 20 are the hardest, and maybe something is missing. But I would say in the last 4 months, we made progress so far that everyone who saw it, oh, could I have one of those? And now I'm in a position that, huh, how many are existing? I think I definitely built 15 of those that I don't own anymore, and now I have about 10 left, and 7 of those are mine. So more than 25 exist, but I don't have all of them. So everyone I showed this to wanted to have one. And then I was building the 15th of them, but didn't have one myself. And at one point, some people started helping, and yeah, we got quite far, I would say. If you want to help, if you want to keep working on this project, if you know about RTMP or want to do anything,
dann kann ich euch nur darauf hinweisen, wenn ihr das Zeug zum Beispiel bestellen
wollt. Then I can just say, if you have any kind of feedback or anything, there's the contact. The top one is not an email address. That is a social media account. The lower one is an email address and the project where all the people I will mention worked on is on GitHub. And thank you, Epic Alex, Kurt Norbert, and everything not mentioned, because it wasn't something I did. It was done by a lot of people. It's based on work that people in Dresden did, and I'm just the one presenting it. I don't even know why. People wanted me to present it, basically.
Und damit, keine Ahnung, der Beweis, dass es in echt existiert.
I also have the proof that it exists in real life. Ich bin
mir nicht 100% sicher, ob man es sieht. Also hier sehen wir
so die, this is the latest version.
Platine. Das ist quasi
that's the version 3.0.
Und hier haben wir noch
and here is version 2,
die Platine, that has a Vorderseite hat, wo auch oben quasi die Pins
few pins that are
Programmierung einzeln macht. Bisschen, dass die Rückseite
on their own. And here is the bug and boost converter as well. And the typical prototype wire that jumpers to make it work. It's not uncommon. But yeah, I hope that's the proof that this works in real life and exists. This is one of the robots, for example.
And
now I'm ready for your questions. Here's one of the version 3.0 that also has 3D printed casing. And here's one made from
thick
cardboard paper. Oh, just cardboard. And here is one of the
first
ones with the gray motors that are very small. So these wheels are thumbnail size, and that the idea was to have it in a matchbox size, and that also worked. And that also runs for many hours. And the big variant with these power banks that officially have 10,000 milliamps, but in reality 6,800, and that runs forever. So 24 hours are quite realistic.
Aber 12 Stunden sind immer das, was ich sage. Und da kommt es auch so ein bisschen drauf an.
And it also depends on if it's running with full steam or just standing around and if it's blinking. But 24 hours, they always make that. Okay, Harald.
Bitte der Harald.
He also has one.
Entschuldigung, das
oh, sorry, the microphone was off there. But I was showing into the camera that I've had my robots here. Thank you for the presentation.
Und es gibt auch
and there are a couple of questions.
Da erst hier etwas provozieren musste im Chat. Daraufhin hat
sich
Big Alex gefunden, der hier schon mal ein paar Fragen eingeworfen hat. Die erste sehr
konstruktiv.
Wie hat Honky es geschafft, um diese Zeit einen kohärenten Vortrag zu haben?
How did you put together all of this in one presentation?
Ganz einfach, warte, dafür kann ich was
ganz I can tell. So my computer broke down yesterday. I can't use certain numbers and the control key. For some reason that broke and I hadn't created slides yet. So yesterday, with the Chaos Zone Party Zone music, I clicked together these pictures. That's how you... Oh yeah, and Chunk helped a lot. So that's how you can have a talk at this time, a coherent talk.
Then the next question, does this scale?
So right now you could not have a lawnmower motor on that, but if it's an electric one, it would run with wheelchair motors. For example, we built something like a couch, and you can have up to 25 amperes per channel. So with the same logic, you could control that, but the motor controller would have to be replaced, and it would have to be a beefy one. And for wheelchairs and the like that exists, and I have a few of those, haha, as if I bought it. Here is one of these H-Bridge motors. Still packaged. So yeah, you can buy that. And in China, it costs between, I think this cost $8 to $10. And it's just a bigger version of the small PCB. And then you can run bigger motors.
Okay. Dann, damit hast du die nächste Frage schon fast beantwortet.
Then you've already answered the next question.
Also ferngesteuerten Sessel
so gibt es schon nicht an RC couch exists not with this technology but technically no problem at all. You just have to do it and that needs time and then there were some events and congress and you know maybe next year.
Machen wir das vielleicht bis nächstes Jahr.
Das ist ja verrückt, diese komischen Dinge, die immer zu...
crazy, all these different things that are put together. Then there's from Little Alex, we have the question. Can you talk more about the motor controller?
So how much current can they handle? I mentioned 1.2 amps per channel, that's 2.4 concurrent.
Die Spannung, die ja durchweg akzeptiert, natürlich
so gewissen Punkt durch at a certain point you could also add cooling, but without it's, I think, 2.4 amps.
Und das heißt 5
Watt. So that depends on the voltage. We are using 5 volts right now, so that's 5 Watts. But theoretically up to 15 volts, so that would be between 15 and 20 Watts per channel.
Pro Kanal.
Okay, also mal zwei. Sehr gut.
Okay, very good.
Und dann bedankt sich Quark für den Vortrag.
Quark says thank you for the presentation.
Du hast nur 64 Follower auf
and then you already have 46 followers on Mastodon. Du noch mehr kriegst.
Vielen Dank, das würde mich sehr freuen.
Yeah, thank you. I would like more followers.
Genau, das waren dann erstmal die Fragen.
Then those were the questions.
Und, dann würde ich sagen, machen wir
schon. And this concludes our presentation.
Ich verabschiede mich auch von euch.
And we're saying goodbye from the stream.
Ich war das auch mein letzter Vortrag beim RC3S Herald.
And we wish you a lot of fun.
Dass der Corona-Quatsch bald vorbei ist und wir uns.
And we'll see you next time. Until then.
Tragt immer schön eure
Masken. Please wear your masks and we'll see each other. Bye. Thanks.
Goodbye.